pie that they want. Thank you.
Inside of school or online, and we come together to end it. We're here because we want to impart our knowledge and our experiences from the past, such as in middle school and in high school, to make the transition easier for you guys, and hopefully to make, you know, it's just a smoother transition into high school.
Alright, so a couple of years back, CBS, the news program, came to Tracy High, and they recognized Bulldog Project's efforts to putting an end to bullying, so they interviewed us, and take a look.
Okay.
They're taking a stand. A group of local high school students is battling cyberbullying in a unique way.
I think the problem is social media and kids thinking they can just say whatever they want.
The project started a few years ago at Tracy High School, and students use a unique partnership to crack down on bullies in their community.
New tonight, CBS 13's Kelly Ryan gives us a look inside this community effort.
It's called the Bulldog Project, and it's being recognized across the state for taking a stand against bullying.
We're always on the lookout when we try to stop bullying as much as we can.
Tracy High School senior Lauren Perry is a member of an on-campus club that's taking a public stand, getting rid of all forms of bullying.
When we see something, our members of our club, we text our group message and we try to, you know, get that page down if so many people report them.
These days, a big part of bullying takes place in cyberspace.
I think the problem is social media and kids thinking they can just say whatever they want and it won't affect the other person.
The Bulldog Project was started 2 years ago and has already been recognized with awards and a special invitation to the state capitol.
It was a great honor to be there. We were just being recognized for our accomplishments.
The club entered into a unique partnership with Tracy Crime Stoppers, allowing kids to report bullying without fear of retaliation.
As part of Crime Stoppers, you can like report anonymously about anything. So that was like a part of the club that we incorporated. So if you're too scared to report or you don't know how to report, you can use the Crime Stoppers tip number.
Tracy High School administrators say the club has helped them to identify cases of bullying early on.
The kids coming in and letting us know. I do see a spike in that, an increase, which is great because then we can try to go in and head it off at the pass.
And school officials are quick to recognize the club members' ability to reach students peer-to-peer.
It's the students having the power to go out and make the difference and saying, we're done. We're done with the bullying.
Bulldog Project members admit it's not always easy fighting against bullying, but say it's been rewarding seeing the difference they can really make.
Even if you just help someone else, just one person, it's better like sticking up to that crowd and helping that one person than not at all.
Organizers are encouraging other schools to contact them so they can spread the Bulldog Project across the state.
And the Bulldog Project isn't just partnered with Tracy Crime Stoppers. The group also works with Students Speaking Out and Entourage Events SF to put an end to bullying.
Okay, so as you guys saw, that video was mainly about Bulldog Project. That's because their partnership with us at Kimball High has only happened for the past few months. And so we've actually been working really hard over the summer to make sure that we can also provide this program for Kimball High feeder schools such as George Kelly. So we're very pleased for you guys to have us today. Thank you. And up next, we have our character count. So you guys are probably familiar with this, but we just want to run through them to remind you about what it takes to be successful.
Hi, my name is Jenna, and I'm a senior from Tracy High, and I'm going to talk to you about doing the right thing. Don't fall under peer pressure, do what is right, and follow the rules because they're cool.
Hello, my name is Kevin Hernandez. I am a senior at Tracy High as well, and I'll be talking about friendship. If someone looks like they need a friend, go ahead and be that friend. Always making friendships can help you build relationships you never know you had, and it's a great way to meet new people.
Hi, my name is Erica. I'm also a senior at Tracy High. One of the first pillars of being a good character is caring. Showing that you care means that you help people in need, forgive others, and are kind to everyone.
Hey guys, I'm Katie. Another pillar of character is fairness, and that means taking turns, playing by the rules, avoiding blaming others and listening to the ideas of others as well.
Hi, I'm Cole, and I am a junior at Tracy High, and I'm here to talk to you about citizenship. Now, having good citizenship is helping making things better. You respect authority and obey laws. You protect the environment, and you're active in your community. Having good citizenship may seem like a big deal, but it could be something as simple as giving someone a smile or picking up a piece of trash.
Hi, my name is Chad Krogh, and I'm a junior at Tracy High School, and I'll be talking about responsibility. Responsibility is to practice self-control, be accountable for your actions, finish what you begin, and your best and keep on trying.
Hi, I'm Kara Sunshin, and I'm a sophomore from Kimball High School. Showing respect is using like good manners and being considerate of others and never putting them down no matter what they believe. And it's also to never bully or hurt anyone physically.
Hey guys, my name is Kritika, and I'm a freshman at Kimball High School, and to be trustworthy is to be honest and reliable, be loyal to your family and friends, always do the right thing, and never lie, cheat, or steal.
Hi, my name is Sam, and I'm a senior at Tracy High, and I'm going to talk to you guys about being awesome. Being awesome is being yourself, being a leader, not a follower, and always doing what is right.
Hi, my name is Erica. I'm a junior at Kimball High. And to wrap up, remember that kindness is contagious. So always do the right thing. If you see something, say something. Don't just stay in by my standard. Always perform nice gestures because, believe it or not, they do get passed on. And always report to Tracy Crime Stoppers if you can't solve the problem on your own.
All right, everybody, give a hand for character count. Alright guys, so you guys are in middle school, 7th and 8th graders. 8th graders, you guys are going to be going to high school in a couple of months. And 7th graders, you guys are going to be going in about a year. So we just want to calm your nerves a little bit and just tell you guys what to expect when you go to high school.
Hey guys, my name is Kritika. I'm a freshman at Kimball. So how many of you guys are going to go to Tracy?
Yeah.
Awesome. And then how many of you guys are going to go to Kimball? Okay, so I went to George Kelly, and one of the biggest changes for me going into high school was that you guys are a K-8 school, so you've been together for what, like 8-9 years now? So when you go to your new high school, you're going to meet a lot of new people, which is really fun and great. And one advantage that you guys have is that since you've been together for so long, you have a really good support system going into high school.
So one of the things that we do at both Kimball and Tracy High School to help you transition is freshman orientation. So at Kimball, we call it mentorship, and at Tracy, they call it link crew. And basically, it's before the beginning of the new year, and you're just going to come in, you get into small groups, and you have a mentor that's either a junior or senior, and they help show you around the school, get you used to everything. You guys play some fun games and meet a lot of people, and it's definitely a good way to like start the year off and just get used to everything. And also, sorry, throughout the year, that mentor is always going to be there at the school for you if you have any questions or need help.
Hey guys, my name is Amryn. I'm a senior at Kimball High School, and I'm going to talk about homecoming. So homecoming is the most packed, most spirited, and wild week in high school. There's a powder puff game where the girls play football and the guys cheerlead. There's a night rally in the football stadium to get you all hyped up for that Friday, because that Friday every school will do a homecoming parade at downtown Tracy. And then you'll go back to your school for a football game, and then after the football game there's a homecoming dance, so be ready for that.
Hi guys, I'm Macy. I'm a senior at Kimball High School. So I'm going to talk to you guys about Spirit Days, kind of like homecoming. So during homecoming week, we have a Spirit Week where we go, like, all of us as a school, we dress up like mixed match day, like crazy hat day. We all basically come together and we just show our spirit for the school.
Hey guys, I'm Wesley. I'm a junior at Tracy High. I'm here to talk to you about rallies. So throughout the school year at Tracy High, we have 5 different rallies. Each rally is based on different themes and is spread out throughout the year. At the rallies, basically, we all sit in different sections, either by academic GPA or by your class, you know, juniors, seniors, stuff like that. And we either play games or watch performances. Basically, we all just get together and have fun.
Hi guys again. We also do this thing where we have a student section. So at both high schools, at Kimball High School, we have the jungle, and at Tracy High School, they have the dog pound.
Yeah, we have dog pound. In the student sections, we go to the games, either basketball, football, soccer. You know, we just go to a bunch of different sports games, and we basically just sit and cheer on and stand and, you know, chant for our teams. And, you know, we have pom-poms, we have necklaces like these. We just have a bunch of stuff. So basically, we just go cheer on our teams and get together and have fun.
Hi, my name is Amanda, and I'm the senior at Tracy High, and I'm going to talk to you about something called Club Rush. So every week, every September, there's a week where every club will set up a table outside of the gym at school, and you can walk around during your lunches and find different clubs that you're interested in and plan on joining during the year. And that's a really good way to get involved with extracurriculars at school. I'm also going to talk to you about the Ag Science program. So for kids that are going to Tracy or interested in finding a way to transfer to Tracy, the Ag Science program is a four-year program where you are kind of kept separate from the rest of your classes because you're in the same group of 60 kids for all 4 years. And each year there's something that you have to do that sets you apart from everyone. Like freshman year, you take a geography elective, which isn't offered to anyone else. And there's two separate tracks of ag. So I took the lab science track, so it prepared me to go into IV sciences like biology and chemistry.
Hey guys, I'm Nick. I'm a senior at Tracy High, and I also am in ag. Although I took a different path for ag, I am in the FFA portion, and we study the agricultural side of biology and whatnot. So, yeah.
Hi, I'm Haley. I'm a junior at Kimball, and I'm here to talk to you guys about pre-AP or AP classes. So how many of you guys are planning on or already signed up to take an AP class? Okay, well for those of you who did, you made a really good decision. And those of you who haven't, I advise you to think about it later on in high school. AP or pre-AP classes are advanced, more rigorous classes. You can take it for your history, your science, a foreign language, or math. Pre-AP and AP classes, they raise your GPA, so an A counts for 5 points instead of four, so you can have higher than a 4.0, and they prepare you for college courses, so I highly recommend taking some.
Hi, my name is Gabby, and I'm a senior at Tracy High School. So how many of you guys play a sport? Raise your hand. That's awesome. So at Tracy, in high school, the sports are like the fun aspect of high school, and there's always going to be an interest in sports, whether you're doing football or something smaller like cross country, or you wouldn't have a rugby team. So you're going to find a lot of fun in sports, and you're going to meet a lot of great people.
So guys, my name is Soham Gupta. I asked you guys how many people are playing sports, but we're going to look at what sports you guys are playing. Who's playing volleyball high school? All right, who's playing baseball? What about basketball? How about football? All right, so basically, if you're going to Tracy High, you're gonna be on the better team. But sports is a huge thing. So I mean, definitely continue it. Sports in high school is way different than youth football, youth basketball. That it's a fun little gig. You build a little family. You have your own group. I mean, we have my coach. Coach Trout's son right here, he can tell you, he's been around the locker room a lot. Jake, put your hand up real quick, bro. Yeah, so I mean, he'll tell you about it, what the football locker rooms are like. It's a fun environment, so definitely take part in sports. So now Michael's gonna take it over and introduce you guys to something cool.
Okay, give it a round of applause for our representative. Just for the record, Kimball also has a very good sports team. We actually entered playoffs for girls basketball, and we won sections for our water polo.
Yeah, our football team beat them like 40-0.
Okay, up next, we have a little scenario about a bystander and ally, and what to do during a bullying situation.
Hello class, for today's project please find a partner.
Hey Brody, do you want to be my partner?
Sure.
Hey Brody, do you want to be my partner?
She actually already asked me, sorry.
Oh, whatever.
Who the heck is she?
I don't even know.
Ding.
Excuse me? I don't know who the heck you think you are. Don't you ever try to steal my partner away from me like that ever again.
Yeah.
Bye.
Whoa, whoa, break it up, ladies. Break it up.
Whatever.
Kel, did you just see what happened?
Yeah, those girls were being so mean.
Yeah, but I mean, we need to get the class, so it's whatever.
Oh my god. That's me right there.
Alright, hi everyone, my name is Valerie Bornese and I'm a junior at Tracy High School and I'm vice president of the Bulldog Project. And really quick, what Sohan forgot to say is that we also have cheer and dance programs and they're really good, so join them. But what just happened in that scenario? Can anyone guess?
Someone got bullied.
What did they do?
They ignored it.
They ignored it. So what that is called is being a bystander. So a bystander is somebody that sees something happens and says nothing. So we want you to know that you should never be a bystander, because when you're a bystander, you witness something happen and you didn't do anything about it. So instead of helping them, you basically hurt the person by watching it happen and not saying anything. So let's see what they can do instead.
Don't you ever try to steal my partner away from me like that ever again.
Yeah.
Bye.
Whoa, whoa, break it up, lady. Break it up.
God, whatever.
Yo, did you just see what happened?
Yeah, those girls were so mean. We should go see if she's okay.
Yeah, definitely.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Just ignore them. They don't even know you. Just, it's fine.
You can sit with us during lunch if you want.
Wow, really, guys? Thanks.
Come on, come on.
Alright, so someone other than him, tell me what happened right there. Like, what was the right thing to do?
Anyway.
What's your name? And what do you think? Absolutely, so Spencer hit around the spot. That's exactly what happened. So the first scenario wasn't the perfect scenario, right? Because the reality of it is people are gonna get bullied all the time. But it's up to people around them to change that culture of it. And yeah, so Amanda and... Okay,
Wesley.
Amanda and Wesley, they helped fix that environment, right? So...
Really quick, does anyone know what it's called when you do that? Anyone? Raise your hand if you take a guess. It's okay if you're wrong. I didn't know. Anyone? Go ahead.
Sexual harassment.
Okay.
We're
talking about what? We're talking about what Leslie and Amanda did. Anybody else want to guess?
Citizenship?
Good, good. That's a good try. So when you're see something happen and you say something or go up to the person and ask if they're okay, that's actually called being an ally. So the difference between a bystander and an ally is a bystander is someone that sees something happen and says nothing. But an ally actually goes and approaches the situation and does something about it.
Alright, so throughout this whole presentation, we're going to be really honest with you guys, but we expect you guys to be honest with us too, alright? We have seniors of people all through high school around here, so I'm going to ask you guys a question real quick. Who's ever been bullied? Raise your hand.
Oh, I'm being bullied right now.
Some of you guys have never been bullied.
Garda.
Swear.
I'm being bullied right now.
All right, well, for the people that haven't been bullied or they're too cool to admit that they've ever been bullied, congrats. But.
All right, so how many of you have been the bully?
I swear.
or if it's at school and you're dealing with a lot of classes or you have a lot of stress on ourselves, we sometimes take that out on others, and instead of being kind to someone, we can say something we don't actually mean. And so I know a lot of us, we're all good people, everyone in here is good people, but sometimes we get to make poor decisions and that makes us the bully.
All right, cool. You want to hit that?
Hey, let's give a round of applause for Mallory and Soma. Okay, raise your hand if you've seen some of the Kimball spirit and the pictures that I've been going on social media. There you go. And Tracy High. Okay, if there's one thing that I'm going to tell you guys about high school is that being spirited, dressing up for spirit days is a cool thing. Right, everyone?
Yeah!
So right now, I'm going to encourage you guys, go ahead and take off your cool jacket. So go ahead. Because we want you to participate, feel comfortable, so that you can feel what it's like to have some spirit.
Even though high school can get kind of serious, you know, when you're studying a lot or you might be going through some stuff, high school can be really, really fun. So, we're gonna have a rally! Okay guys, so one of our most important methods that Kimball Jaguar Project uses and Bulldog Project uses when we see cyberbullying is something called stop, block, save, and tell. So this is how it goes. The first thing, if you see somebody getting cyberbullied or if you're getting cyberbullied, what you're gonna do is you're gonna stop. You're not gonna respond to anything that they say and you're gonna assess the situation. The second thing you're gonna do is you're going to block. You're gonna go in their profile and block them so that you can't talk to them anymore and that they can't bully you anymore. The third thing you're gonna do is you're gonna save. You're gonna take a screenshot of the evidence. The last thing you're gonna do is you're gonna tell. What you're gonna do is you're gonna tell an adult, a parent or a guardian or somebody, an adult at school, and show them what just happened. All right, everybody. So we're gonna stop, block, save, and tell. You know you can do it well. Stop, block, save, and tell. You know you can do it well. Stop, and block, and save, and tell. Stop, and block, and save, and tell. Stop, block, 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 save,
Pictures of her.
Pretty messed up. So, at lunch, everyone is gathered around, the guy and all his friends, his buddies, and they have a poster with the inappropriate pictures, and they're chanting, "Where is she?" And the girl is in the bathroom, and she's hiding, trying to avoid the situation.
So, this is a real life story. This happened recently at a high school, and this is how it all played out.
My reputation is ruined.
Oh my God, I can't believe they would do something so horrible. Don't worry, I'm here for you.
I don't think I can do this anymore. I want to go home. I'm ugly, stupid, irrelevant, worthless. This is all my fault. I deserve all of this. I should end it. What if I just ended everything right here, right now?
Okay, so we just saw a situation happen, and there's a whole group of students chanting for her to come out. And the student body actually approved of this. Someone raise your hand and tell me, how do you think that girl felt?
Bad.
Oh my God.
terrible.
Okay, so as everyone was chanting, "Where is she?" the girl was hiding in the bathroom trying to avoid the situation, and she had a friend next to her helping her, or an ally.
Okay, so now the girl is at home, and we have another group of students hanging out together after school after the situation has happened.
You guys, everyone's posting horrible things about the girl at school today. There's even a video of the girl chanting for her to come out. I know she made a mistake, but she doesn't deserve to be embarrassed like that.
I mean, I agree. Should we say something? I mean, I'm not sure if we should intervene, but let's just report it. I don't want to be included in this drama.
Okay, but look, everyone on campus thinks that this was okay. Look at the video. It has so many likes, retweets, and even comments praising the group. This isn't right.
I agree. This is wrong. She doesn't deserve to get humiliated by one mistake. We are just people and we all make mistakes.
We need to do something. Let's report it and let everyone know that this isn't right. Let's use the hashtag #ICanHelp to show that we can stand in solidarity against this. We need to show the girl that even though she made a mistake, we can stand by her and against the bullying.
Whoa, you guys, look at this. Guys, look, everyone else is using the hashtag to show their support.
Okay, so as you guys can tell from the tweets, this did happen, and we did use the hashtag #ICanHelp. So Jaguar Project tweeted, "Everyone makes mistakes, and shaming anyone in public is unacceptable. #ICanHelp."
Bulldog Project tweeted, "Humiliating someone is never okay. People make mistakes, but there's no need to share things that they trusted you with. #ICanHelp."
Another person, a student, they tweeted, "Think before you post. Imagine yourself being the one that everyone says mean things about before putting someone else down. #ICanHelp.
Another person tweeted, "I can't get over what happened today. My biggest concern is for this girl who was publicly humiliated. I'm hoping she's okay. #ICanHelp. These people, they were only about a year older than you guys. Kimball Jaguar Project saw this, and Bulldog Project saw this, and we came together and stood up for the girl. We started tweeting the hashtag, and that actually spread to people who weren't even in the club, to people around the whole town. Everyone supported the girl. Even though she made a mistake, we still showed that we were there for her, and it had a direct impact on her.
The direct effect on the girl was that she did not want to go to school. So the whole entire week after, even though we did use this hashtag and we did show our support, and we did show that, you know, the whole student body that this is not okay, she still wasn't feeling confident about herself. And so, as you can see, one hashtag can be powerful. So when you guys see something like this online, I encourage everyone to use the hashtag. And instead of being a bystander and just scrolling through, don't do that. Use the hashtag and say something positive. Do not attack whoever was attacking, because if you can see, do you see an at symbol on there? Do you see anyone who was tagged? Did we see the attacker tagged on those posts? But when you click that hashtag, when you click those blue letters, you can see all the positive messages. And I was actually in contact with her sister, and her sister told me about the impact that she had on her. Even though she was still discouraged about everything that happened, it still raised her confidence. And you saw her on the floor feeling like she needed to end it right there, right now. If we hadn't done that, then who knows what could have happened. Okay, so let's go ahead and give her a round of applause for our
All right, now next we're going to have Mayor Mr. Robert Rickman.
Okay. Oh my God. Everyone go ahead and take a look at that picture. Someone raise your hand and tell me, what do you see?
A drunk girl on the floor.
So she saw a drunk girl on the floor. Okay, what do you see?
A girl that likes to drink alcohol.
Oh my god.
So a girl that likes to drink alcohol. Anyone notice something subtle? Something that's not too noticeable?
Rough night.
Oh my god.
It's soda. Yeah, got it. You guys at first thought that she was drunk, passed out from alcohol? Well, not really. If you look closely, it's actually a Sprite can and Coca-Cola or Dr. Pepper. Soda. At first, if you were to look at this and you didn't know who she was, you would think that she's that kind of girl and she's drinking and she's passing out. But if you were her friend, you would know that this was actually a joke. So it's really important how you portray yourself online because not everybody may understand what you're trying to say.
So, yeah, so if a stranger comes across this, then that's how you're portraying yourself to them. And one of those strangers could be your next employer in the future. That could be the scholarship company that you have applied for and is going through your social media to see what you're like as an individual. And anything that you post online is never gonna go away, even if you delete it. There's always that IP address, and that's called the digital footprint that you leave when you post something. So whatever you post online is definitely gonna impact you in the future. Does anyone know what this means? Okay, what else on Twitter? What do you call it on Twitter?
Retweet.
Okay, retweets. There you go, favorite it. When you favorite something, when you like something, what does it mean? You like it. That means you approve of it. So if you come across these pictures and you like them, that means you approve of what your friend is doing or you approve of what they're doing. And that also reflects upon you because what you like is is not only how your friends portray yourself, but also it shows up what you approve of. So the next time you come across these things on social media, be careful about what you say and what you do with the posts.
All right, next we're going to have our Mayor Robert Rickman talk to us about anonymous reporting and Tracy Crime Stoppers. Give him a hand.
Bulldog Project for the great job they've always done. I've been on the advisory board since. And Kimball, I'm sorry. I was going to get to you guys. But at the very beginning with the Bulldog Project, they did more to do the Kimball. Kimball came on board, so thank you both. You guys do a great job. Now, I am your mayor. I'm also a police sergeant for the state of California. But you know, one of my greatest accomplishments is. Thing I hold dear to me is being a Bulldog. And I know many of you are going to the Kimball High School, and when I was in school, we just had Tracy High. And your assistant principal, Mrs. Petty, her and I actually classmates together. Now, what we're here today to tell you is about, you know, see something, say something. If you do see bullying in your school, or see bullying around, to do something. And trust us, I know it's a hard thing to do. We can sit up here and tell you, hey, to do something, but we know it's a tough thing. But you have to have the courage to get involved. And there are certain things that you do because you do it because it's the right thing to do. And that's what we're here to talk about. If you see something, there's multiple ways to report it. One way is through the Tracy Crime Stoppers. If you don't want to get involved, I know a lot of people don't want to get involved, don't want to feel the peer pressure, don't want people to know who exactly is telling on them. And you hear that, you know, the saying of snitching and stuff like that. And let me tell you what, being a police officer, being your mayor, and don't worry about that. A lot of great things have come to the city, to this country, to the school, because people do the right thing. And this is what we're asking. One way to get involved without having somebody know who you are is through Tracy Crime Stoppers. And Tracy Crime Stoppers partners with the Bulldog Project and partners with the Tracy Police Department. It's a nonprofit organization. And you can report what you see to that number anonymously, so nobody knows who you are. Since this program has been part of Tracy, part of our school district, part of the city, There's a lot of kids that have been helped. If you look over here to my left, you see the Kimball and Tracy High. These are leaders. These are not just leaders in their school, but they're leaders in the community. We can't do it ourselves. We need your help. Everybody in this room, your seventh to eighth graders, like it or not, you are leaders. You're leaders in this school. When you step up, you're going to be leaders in the high school. People look up to you. When I sat in your spot when I was in seventh and eighth grade, the people that I looked up to were the high school. One thing I always wanted to be was a Bulldog. Some of you are going to be Bulldogs. Most of you are going to be Jaguars. And it's something to strive to. Be proud of your school. Make your school the best school in the city. It'd be kind of tough because you have Tracy High there. But anyways, just joking. But also, I'm also here for you guys. I work for you. If you ever need anything from me, contact City Hall, leave me a message. I will get back to you. All right? You guys are our future. You are our leaders. And I want to thank you all very, very much.
Talk about some personal and sensitive issues that most of us would have a hard time talking about. So, real talk, come on out.
Hi guys, my name is Brody Sarsfield. I'm a senior at Tracy High. And I'm going to talk about self-esteem and confidence. So I'm going to start off with a quick question. Raise your hand if you ever felt as if you were worthless or incomplete or felt down on yourself. So, that's a good, I'd say like 99%. Well, if you guys take a look at everyone around you, everyone's different. Everyone's unique. Everyone has their own special things about them. And no one should ever talk down on you. No one should ever put you down, no one should ever do that, because if you look around, you're going to be around these people for a long time. And these are all your family, and these are all your brothers and sisters, and we should treat each other as if we were a family.
Hi, I'm Kiana, I'm a senior at Kimball, and I'm going to be talking to you about being a bystander. So, I know Mallory explained what it meant to be a bystander when we had that skit, and it's important that you are not a bystander. So as a reminder, a bystander is someone who sees something that's not good and doesn't say anything. You don't want to be that person. You want to be the person that makes a change, reports it, and, you know, gets involved.
Hi, I'm Cammy. I'm a senior at Kimball. So I'm going to talk about bullying. I know we've already talked a lot about it, but I just want to do a little recap. So I know most of you raised your hand saying that you've either been bullied or you've been a bully. And I think that really opened my eyes when we first did this activity to how many people have gone through what I had gone through and to see that I'm not alone. Like, bullying is something that adults go through, middle school, high schoolers, everyone goes through bullying. So we all need to work together to put a stop to it.
Hi guys, I'm Sam. I'm a junior at Tracy High School, and I'm going to talk to you guys about cliques. Throughout life, and especially school, you have a group of friends who you're more drawn to. That's going to happen. But it's important that you make that group of friends a positive impact on your life. There are going to be mean girl cliques, and you're trying to exclude people. And especially with that transition from middle school to high school, there's a huge gap in friends. There's going to be a lot more people. But it's important to be open to everyone, to open to new friends. And I know I've met so many new people throughout my years in high school.
All right, so when we first ask questions, someone says sexual harassment, right? Let's remember that because you guys all laughed. Now, we kind of have to think about if you wanted to talk to you guys about it. But you guys are all in eighth grade, right?
No, we're seniors too?
Okay, well, we won't go into that much detail then. But it's important for you guys to understand what sexual harassment is. So we're actually going to... You guys can go. So, We're gonna actually show you guys a video first and then explain what happens through it. So if Derek wants to do an audio pod video.
Sheriff's deputies arrived at Saratoga High School before noon today and arrested two teenaged boys. A third teenager who used to go to Saratoga was also arrested at his new school in Gilroy. All of the 16-year-olds are accused of attacking Audrey Pott.
What happened to Audrey was tragic. It should never have happened. I hope that they're brought to justice.
Detectives say on September 2nd of last year, Audrey was at an unsupervised house party. She drank too much and passed out. That's when they say three fellow classmates took advantage.
She has no idea what occurred until she woke up the following morning and had some drawing on her body and some private areas.
The boys also took photos during the attack and not only showed them off at school, but also texted and posted them online. Audrey quickly found out and posted this on her Facebook page. Quote, "They took pictures of me. My life is ruined. This is the worst day ever." The 15-year-old took her own life a few days later.
So how many of you guys actually knew the story? How many of you guys? All right, so there's a couple of you guys. And I don't know if you guys caught it, but this girl was only a freshman at the time, right? And a lot of you guys are gonna be freshmen next year. And the reality of it is we're all gonna go to parties. We're all gonna see people drinking. And people make choices. And really, we're not here to tell you what choice to make. We want you to guide you guys in the right direction. But we can't make that choice for you. When you're at a party, when you're having fun, we're not gonna be there. It's gonna be up to you to what you do. And it's gonna be up to you to take control of yourself. So this Audrey Pott situation, I kinda wanna add some more detail to it. It's a rough journey. And it's not an isolated incident, right? It's an incident that really got brought up because her parents did something about it. But there's incidents like this happening all the time. There's people that go to parties. There's people that get raped. There's people that get sexually harassed. And some choose to speak up, some don't. My brother's in college. He knows a bunch of people that have been victims of sexual assault and as far as rape, but they choose not to speak up because they're afraid of the consequences. And that's not always the best choice. But once again, we can't make that choice for you. So our job really is to prepare you guys and make you guys understand that it's not a joke. I mean, you guys see it on movies, you guys see it in medias, stuff happens. It's like movies all the time about rape victims. I'm sure you guys heard about the Stanford case where the dude only got 3 months. Cases like that happen, all right? It's the real world. But they can be stopped too. You guys heard how there was three guys that did that to her. You think one of those guys didn't think that, what the hell am I doing? Why am I doing this? You think none of them said that? But it's peer pressure. All of their friends are doing it, they're gonna do it. So it's up to you to stick up. I mean, at that point, your friends might be like, and it's not in this situation, any situation where there's peer pressure, your friends might be like, why are you stopping us from doing this? But you gotta think about the consequences. You think when they did it, you thought this girl was gonna take her life? No. But did she? Yeah. You can never tell what's going on in someone else's life from what you see. And everyone in this room can relate. I mean, me and Mallory are close, but I don't know everything that's going on in her life. And if something were to happen, I can't sit here and tell you guys every detail. So really, I want you guys to look at Audrey Pott's situation and just be wise before you make decisions. I mean, I'm not like everyone's going to make bad decisions, but think about how it's going to affect others. And I know that's so cliche, everyone says, I'm sure your teachers say it all the time too, but it's probably the truest statement. Think about what's gonna happen before you do something.
One thing I wanna touch on is, although that was really, really tragic what happened to Audrey and we were really upset about it, one positive thing that came out of it was her parents actually started the Audrey Pott Foundation, and you might've seen it at the end, but they got Audrey's Law passed, which is Senate Bill 838. And what it does is it makes the perpetrators, so those three guys would have been not anonymous in court now if that law was passed back when that happened. Or so her family actually travels around and talks about the Audrey Pott Foundation, and we've actually teamed up with them, and we hosted a launch rally for her law, and we also hosted a movie showing for Audrey and Daisy, which is on Netflix if you want to watch it. But also, I want to talk to you about teen dating violence. So how many of you have been in a relationship or know you're going to date someone in high school? Like, it happens. I'm not going to tell you not to get into a relationship. But I can tell you half of Bulldog Project's been in one. But the thing is, you have to remember that it's tough getting close to someone that you don't know very well. And if you ever in a situation where you feel uncomfortable in your relationship, or even just uncomfortable with a friend that you have, make sure you speak up and tell someone, because you might not think it's that big of a deal, but it might turn into something bigger. So if you ever feel uncomfortable with someone, even if you're just their friend, make sure that you speak up about it or say something and defend yourself, because it's your body and it belongs to you and it's not anybody else's, so don't let anyone treat it like it is.
Michael. All right, cool. I hope you guys understood something from that.
Okay, so with that, we have our It's On Us video, which is, we filmed this recently with the Bulldog Project and Jaguar Project about kind of just a call to action with what happened to Audrey Pott. So.
Teenagers sexually assaulted Audrey. In the following days, Audrey was bullied by peers who saw photographs posted on social media that were taken during Audrey's assault. On September 12, 2012, Audrey decided to take her own life. Today, the Audrey Pott Foundation provides anti-cyberbullying presentations to school-aged teens. On September 30th, 2014, California Governor Jerry Brown signed Audrey's Law, which is a bill that increases penalties and decreases privacy protections for teens convicted of sex acts on someone who is passed out from drugs or alcohol or incapable of giving consent due to a disability. The Tracy High School Bulldog and Kimball High School Jaguar projects in Tracy, California have united to spread awareness for the Audrey Pott Foundation and support Audrey's Law, Senate Bill 838.
At Tracy High and Kimball High, we're taking steps to do the right thing.
We are two schools that care for each other.
That supports one another.
And it starts here.
And it starts now.
It's on us.
All of us.
All of us.
It's on us to create a kinder environment where everyone feels safe.
Putting an end to bullying, cyberbullying, and violence.
Taking responsibility of our actions.
Having the courage to report what we see.
Most importantly, don't be the bystander.
Stand up.
Protect one another.
It's on us to be a friend.
Creating a culture of respect and kindness.
Supporting one another.
Being a friend to lead.
It's on all of us.
It's on us to listen.
It's not just a dramatic problem.
It's not just a dumb bad thing.
And we can't pretend that cyberbullying, bullying, and violence are not issues.
Talk to each other.
Face to face.
With an open heart and mind.
Drugs and alcohol are not an excuse.
Don't let alcohol or drugs get in the way of good decisions.
Be there for them. Talk about what's okay and what's not okay.
Help them to think about what they are doing.
Are you doing the right thing?
We cannot do this on our own.
But together, we are stronger.
If you see someone headed in the wrong direction, stand up, intervene.
If you see something that isn't right and you need to report it anonymously, contact Tracy Crime Stoppers and it will be investigated.
What happens here affects all of us.
All of us.
It's on us to look out for each other.
Not look the other way.
To be a part of the solution.
Not a part of the problem.
So put a stop to tearing ourselves and others down.
Join our movement today to be kind and respect your peers.
And end bullying, cyberbullying, and violence.
Make good decisions.
It's on us.
Do the right thing.
It's on us.
Partner up with the Tracy High Bulldog Project
and the Kimball High Jaguar Project.
It's on us.
Be the difference.
It's on us.
So throughout all of our presentation, we've been talking about people that get bullied, right? We've been talking about bystanders, we've been talking about allies. But the one thing that we didn't talk too much about is the person that bullies someone. And we're quick to judge people that bully others, right? If you see your friend getting bullied, you're like, man, that dude sucks. Like, why is he bullying my friend? But it's important that you guys don't isolate them either. Because, like I said, no one knows what's going on in other people's lives, right? The bully, quote-unquote, he might have something going on in his house. He might have parents going through a divorce. He might have a brother that's sick. He might have something that's going on, right? You guys all heard the term, don't fight fire with fire, add fuel to the fire. And that's exactly what it is. You guys don't want to attack a bully, because really that solves nothing. And we use the word bully a lot, but it hits a huge span of things. So don't just take the word bully as like one isolated thing. I want to give you guys a little example real quick. I sucked at sports. I sucked really bad. I sucked at basketball, I sucked at soccer, I sucked at all of that. And I really wanted to play sports. And there was this guy, and he was the bully of the school, right? This was back in elementary school. And I was a nerd. I was kind of scared to go talk to them. And when I went to go play football, obviously they said no. I had glasses, I had skinny jeans on, I was different. And they rejected me. But then the guy that everyone called the bully, right? He's the one who eventually let me play. So if it wasn't for the bully, I would have never played football. So I want you guys to realize that even though you guys might feel attacked by some people, they have stuff going on in them too. So I mean, you guys don't want to raise your hand or anything, but if you know that you're bullying someone or you're rude to someone, bring that nice part of you out too, man. I mean, it makes a huge difference. Like, just look at me. I wouldn't have ever played football if it wasn't for my friend who used to bully me, if his nice side didn't come out. So I really advise you guys that if you guys are rude to someone, be true to yourself. I mean, that's the biggest thing throughout life. Be true to yourself. No one knows you more than you know yourself. Just be nice and be kind. All right, so we're going to actually conclude it with something else real quick. If you want to hit it.
All right, guys. For our next and our final segment, we're going to be doing Kindness Is. Some members are going to be coming out and giving you guys some actions of kindness that you all can do in your everyday lives.
Hey guys, so before we go, we're going to be telling you guys a little bit about what kindness is. And to be honest, kindness isn't just one thing. Kindness is
helping somebody with their homework,
accepting others,
being supportive,
smiling at someone in the hallway,
asking someone if they're okay,
not excluding others,
being there when they need you the most,
encouraging each other. These are the many ways of what kindness is.
Okay guys, so after you heard a few examples, I hope you can implement these things into your lives, and just know that kindness makes a huge difference on your lives and everyone else's. Thank you.
Thanks guys. All right you guys, that's a wrap. Thank you everyone, thank you staff, thank you to the students. You guys are so great and participative, and we just wanted to thank you all for coming out here and listening to us talk. You guys are awesome. Make sure you guys follow us on our social media at THSBPP.
And at JAG Project, at KJP JAG Project. We hope that you guys got something out of our presentation today, and we hope that you will join Jaguar Project if you do go to Kimball, or Bulldog Project if you go to Tracy High. As you guys exit, a few members also have our stickers, #ICanHelp, to remind you to post positively on social media. So if you can put it on your phone and remind each other that we need to spread positivity and use kindness in our everyday lives. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Yeah. Don't stop, hey. Don't stop, hey.